Welcome to Prison Architect. We're going to be doing full campaign mode.
So brace yourselves.
Sometimes my computer crashes. So if it crashes, I might not be able to do the video. But if it doesn't, hurrah!
Now let's go.
My blue computer doesn't have very much space at the park. I'm trying to move on the game and run out of this space. This is a tough one. He's a prisoner incarcerated at this facility who's been convicted of a double murder and sentenced to death. That's where we come in. We've been contracted to construct an execution chamber in time for the guy's big day. This is where I want the new facility to be built. First step with any project like this is to construct the building itself with enough space to fit an execution room and a holding cell. So let's get started. Construct a new building here. We will also need an entrance to the new execution facility. Put a large jail door into the south wall. Your workmen are responsible for the construction of buildings. They'll collect the steel and concrete from the storeroom and take it to the construction site. They'll use those raw materials to build the foundation and framework of their new building. This is the slowest part of construction, so you should plan ahead when you need the supports. While we wait, take a look around. Use WASD for the arrow keys. Go out. Use the mouse to zoom in and out, which I don't have. But I do know how to zoom out without using the mouse. Just press E or Q to zoom in and out. See? Press E or Q. U zooms in, E zooms out. Partition the space by constructing some brick walls. No! and large steel doors to those dividing walls. You can rotate an object before placement by clicking the middle mouse button or press R. It's looking good. You need to designate rooms within those spaces. Designate a cell in the smaller area where a condemned inmate will live. Then designate the execution room itself. Those new rooms have requirements before they become functional. The cell needs a bed and a toilet. The execution room requires the electric chair. That's the essentials taken care of, but there are still a few improvements you can make. It's up to you though, these aren't strictly required. It depends how much you care about your prisoners and their environment. The cell itself could be improved with an outward facing window and a small bookshelf. And the facility would look better with higher quality floor material like wooden floorboards or mosaic tiles. Outside, you could add some lighting and a paved pathway if you think it needs it. This is the man in question, Edward Romsey. Teacher wants what you believe. It's not our place to decide if he deserves this. The law has made that decision. We're just here to do a job. Once you are satisfied with the facility, ready, you can begin a prisoner transfer to his cell. Simply click on the Polaroid in his cell to initiate the transfer. There are some things I missed. Let's restart this chapter. Already watched that. There's a prisoner incarcerated. That's where we come in. We've been contacted to construct the execution chamber. Tell me where the bad's been dead. This is where I want the new facility to be built. This, the first step in any project like this is to construct the building itself. Less space inside to fit an execution and a holding cell. So let's get started. Construct the new building. We'll also need an entrance to the new execution facility. Put a large steel door into the cell wall. workmen are responsible for the construction of buildings. They'll collect the steel and concrete from the storeroom and take it to the construction site. They'll use those raw materials to build the foundations and framework of your new building. This is the slowest part of construction, so you should plan ahead when building new facilities. While we wait, take a look around, use WASD or the arrow keys to move around and use the mouse wheel to zoom in and out. Like I said before, you can use E to zoom out. Inside the building, I want a cell and execution room. Partition the space by constructing some brick walls. No. I'm kidding. Add large deal doors to the keys dividing walls. You can rotate an object for placement by clicking the middle mouse button or press R. That's looking good. We need to designate rooms within those spaces. Designate a cell in the smaller area where our condemned inmate will live. Then designate the execution room itself in the larger area. Those new rooms have requirements before they can, or they become functional. The cell needs a toilet and a bed. Needs a bed and a toilet. The execution room requires the electric chair. That's the essentials taken care of. But there are still a few improvements you could make. It's up to you, though. These aren't strictly required. It depends how much you care about your prisoners and their environment. The cell itself could be improved with an outward-facing window and a small bookshelf. The facility would look better with a higher quality floor material like wooden floorboards or mosaic tiles. Outside, you could add some lighting and a paved pathway if you think it needs it. This is the man in question, Edward Ronson. Teacher once, but do you believe? It's not our place to decide if he deserves this or if he deserves this. The law has made that decision. We're just here to do a job. Once we're satisfied the facility is ready, we can begin the prisoner transfer to his new cell. Simply click on the Polaroid in his cell to initiate the transfer. Thank you. And
thank you.
Alabama. Emilio! The needle turned out to be Emilio. '77 through '66. Emilio! Emilio turned out to be Emilio. Thank you.
Good old urine!
steel to work now.
Okay, then I'm okay.
Peanut butter. Check 1-2 for this guy. He's a stone-cold killer, guilty as charged. He even confessed. Want to hear his description of what he did? It's juicy stuff. It was around 11 p.m. Lights were already on. I knew she was home. Thank you. I'll take that. Day, if you ask me, he deserves everything before he's gonna be. All men deserve forgiveness, even him. Are you so sure in yourself that you can deal out such a final judgment? Catching your wife with another man, it's no excuse for what he did. And he went there with a loaded gun, knowing he'd find them together. That's double premeditated murder. He's done nothing but cooperate with the authorities. This state is making an example of him. If he committed his crime 100 miles north, he'd be looking at life imprisonment instead. How is that justice? You want a guy like this running free? I'll sleep just fine at night when I know he's gone. Work so far. However, there is one problem. The execution room isn't functioning yet because it doesn't have any power. We need to connect it to the electrical supply. We are now viewing the prison in utilities mode, which shows us the electrical wiring layout for the entire prison. Each building in the prison is connected to the power grid by these thick underground electrical cables. Power is provided to the prison by this substation, which draws electricity from the national grid. As you can see, this entire wing of the prison cells is without power. All of the lights are out. To fix this problem, we first need to switch into utilities to understand why the lights are out. Without power. The nearest electrical cables are too far away. Our engineers can't complete the wiring for this area. Extend the electrical cables nearby to cover the swing of the prison. Okay, Mom, I know! Go away! Sorry, that was nothing, Mom! No, I don't! Sorry about that, that was my mom. Lights aren't the only thing that needs power. Your new electric chair does too. Use the power cables to connect the execution facility to the power grid. The electric chair itself is a special type of electrical item. It requires its own dedicated power line. You need to connect it up directly with the main cables. You know what? I changed my mind. This one is going to be for the day. We are almost done, I think. We should test the new execution room at least once before we try to use it, though. I'm just going to turn it on for a few seconds, make sure everything is okay. That didn't work. Looks like we drew too much power and tripped a circuit breaker in the power station. The whole prison is dark. You're going to need more juice to be able to handle the power spike that the electric chair gives. Oh, I don't know what that said. First, we need to turn the power back on. This is a two-step process. Switch the power station back on by clicking on it and selecting switch on in the menu that appears. Then build three more capacitors so we have enough power capacity to handle the electric chair. Once you've done that, test the electric chair again by clicking on it and selecting switch on in the menu. Well done. I believe we are finished with this job. What happens now is out of our hands. We did a professional job, and that's important in our business. Try not to worry about what happens next. Thank you. sorry. Thank you.